Joining us now on The Balancing Act as part of our book author series is Lois West Duffy, author of Zillah's Gift, a coming-of-age book aimed at girls. But she's finding a wider readership because of the book's themes and its backdrop. And thank you so much for joining us to talk about your book this morning, Lois.
It's my pleasure to be here. Thank you.
Now, this is, like I just said, a coming-of-age story. Who was this book for when you wrote it?
Originally, I wrote it for thinking of kids 8 through 12. And I had it test read by the manuscript by 9-year-old girls who are wonderful readers. They're quite perceptive. They're just coming into an understanding of themselves. But I have found children as young as 7 that say they really like it. A 16-year-old gave it a great review, and I've had grown men tell me it brought them to tears.
Grown men.
And so that I like that because it tells me it touched them in a way that I hadn't expected.
And it can touch a wide audience.
Mm-hmm.
Why did you write this book? Why was it important to you?
Well, the idea came to me back when I was teaching 6th grade Sunday school, and the biblical stories never had girl heroines in them.
Yes.
And I thought that wasn't fair.
Right.
They have to have someone to identify with, and from that time on I started planning it, but I didn't get around to writing it for some years.
And then once you did, you wrote this story. Like you said, it's touched a wide range of people. It's about loss and then acceptance and then renewal.
Right.
Tell me a little bit about that.
Exactly. And I started out intending to write it about loss. I wanted my heroine to start as low as she could be. She has lost her parents. She's an orphan. She has a birthmark that allows people to make fun of her.
Bully her.
To bully her, exactly. And she has no one on her side. And in the process of the story, she has the loss of her father, other losses, and then mentors come in and people that help her along the way. She's open to accepting that help. And through that, she develops the skills to cope with her problems and to rise above them. Yes.
The story can really, it's relatable to people today, especially the bullying aspect of it, because so many young girls especially are dealing with it in today's world of technology and cyberbullying. But this story is set not in modern time, it's set in biblical times.
Right, 2,000 years ago.
Religious story to you?
Well, it has religious themes, but it's not a religious story. I didn't set out to write a religious story. And I wanted to write a story that kids could identify with, whether they're religious or not, and whether they are younger kids or older. And I wanted a story that they could look and say, I'm not alone. This happens everywhere. It happens all around the world. It happens from 1,000 years ago till now. And here is a way to deal with it. With a sense of humor, with the ability to see the bully as someone with problems of his or her own, someone that you can afford to ignore, someone who doesn't have to define you. And that's one of the main things I wanted in this book, is Zillah learns to define herself by what she can do, not by what her weaknesses are, and not the way that the bullies define her.
Right. She defines herself.
Mm-hmm.
You actually now have taken this story, you've taken on a new role of speaker. You actually reach out to all kinds of audiences, and I want to make sure that I get your theme right. Teaching values through a hero's journey. Tell us about what it is that you're doing.
Right. That's when I was actually writing the book. It didn't seem to take shape until I started studying the issues of the hero's journey and how that works and what's involved in that. And then I realized what it needed to be, because we are all on our own hero's journey. We start out, we maybe have a goal that might be sort of fuzzy. We don't know exactly what it is. Mm-hmm. We have things that get in our way. We have to change our path. We have people that come in as mentors and helpers. And we gradually get to the point where we understand the path, and then we can succeed. And we might not succeed in what we set out to do to begin with, but we learn to deal with ourselves, who we are, what we can do, and then we can succeed.
We succeed
and
in
that's
that.
That's what I'm trying to help children and adults learn.
Well, I'm sure you are doing a fantastic job with that and inspiring hundreds and hundreds of people. Thank you so much for joining us and inspiring us with this story and for spending time talking to our audience this morning.
Well, it's a delight. Thank you. It was interesting talking to you.
We appreciate you being here. Now, to find out more about Lois West Duffy, her writing and lectures, and also where you could order Zillah's Gift, just go to loiswestduffy.com.